Contact light. Okay, engine stop.
We copy you down, Eagle.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
In 1969, I was living in Highland Park, Illinois. I was a student at Highland Park High School, 16 years old.
And I remember it really well because I was 9 years old and I got to stay up late.
I was 14. I have a twin sister. We were both 14.
I was a member of the Apollo 12 team, so I was assigned to backup. I was lucky because I could be outside and experience the launch.
I don't have a whole lot of memories of when I was 6 years old, but I do remember that night being with my grandfather in his living room with the big old box TV set up, you know, watching the moon landing and him telling us, you have to remember this, it's really important.
That night, July 20th, it was a Sunday night, I drew the short straw and had to work the 6 to midnight shift. The moon landing was supposed to be around 9 o'clock that night Central Time, so I knew I was going to probably miss it all, but one of my best friends, Guy Phillips, brought his father's 5-inch little Sony black and white TV so I could set it up, put up the aerial, and I could watch.
And astronaut Neil Armstrong would serve as mission commander. The day had come. The moon awaited.
You know, I think every kid that grew up in the 60s...
thought about being an astronaut?
I was certain I was going to be an astronaut.
Having been personally involved with it, it's unquestionably the most gratifying experience of my life.
It wasn't even just an American thing. It was like, oh my gosh, everybody around the world was watching this. And I felt like, wow, I'm here, I get to see it. And to me, it felt like it was like pretty much the most important thing that had happened in my lifetime.
We just had this spring the announcement of the Artemis program that will put humans on the moon in 2024 and will create a permanent presence on a planetary body on the moon by 2028.
There's a lot of things we need to do for our own planet, but I do think that exploration is in our DNA, and going to the moon, I think, is something that's inevitable.
I'm all for continued exploration. It's a great unknown out there. We know a lot more about it than we did 50 years ago. There's still so much more to learn.
I just think we have to do that because that's what we do as human beings. We explore.